Good morning. Thank you for joining us for a little tour of the exhibition. I'm Sam. I'm a white non-binary artist wearing a black jacket, a white t-shirt by Mr. Joe Johnson, some black jeans and a yellow hat. And I'm currently in 87 Gallery with Matt Fratson, who is filming. And they are hosting my exhibition that has been curated by Becky G, and alongside so much help and support and kindness from all of the staff here. And we'll talk about that a bit as we go around. So I'll walk you through to our first artwork. So this is a cylinder made out of poplar plywood, which is the base of it. And the new addition for this exhibition is the interior surface, which is made out of tiles from the Humber Estuary. I'm really interested in kind of tectonic qualities, so different surfaces and how the light plays on them. And in stacking them, I'm considering like the different layers that are present in the Humber mud flats, which kind of appears a lot in the work that you'll see today. So if Matt kind of follows me to the next work we'll talk about. This is a collaboration between Fraser from Miss Print Co, a really cool printmakers that are actually resident in 87 Gallery. So he took a screen print and made this print from an image of one of my scans, a LiDAR scan of the from a train actually in between Hull and Scarborough. I'm quite interested in scanning the environment, looking at how glitches in scans can replicate a lack of access for disabled people, but also how they connect to having a visual impairment. So the LiDAR scan kind of struggles to capture water and complex geometry, and how this connects to my own visual impairment. I have ocular albinism, and I also really struggle with light reflections. The work below is welded steel, and the piece actually fits kind of perfectly around my neck, which I really like, because it talks about the body. It's much like the print above. It references stimming, which is throughout all of my work. So kind of stimming is self-regulatory behavior that a lot of neurodivergent people do. It's often criticized or kind of looked at in kind of a negative way, because people think it's about expressing negative emotions. And my work is often about celebrating stimming, because it can be a way of expressing joy or any range of emotion. So there's like a stimming action moving into the body is what this piece is about. So the work next to it again is a metal work, and again talks about the body, but is just about kind of movement within the body, which has been a real kind of strong theme in my work. So I've got kind of like moving hands and a moving torso represented by the curved metal forms. And just kind of the lines moving through them just show kind of how you can move in space. Yeah, it's my first time kind of working with metal, but I'm gonna kind of carry on. I've previously only made like little armatures that go beneath stuff, but I really like the quality of really thin kind of steel lines, because for me it's almost like drawing in space. So yeah, I'm kind of cool with those. I think they're nice. this work, I had a lot of support from a wonderful man called Quee to make the little vase here that has the monitor on. But this is like a retro TV magnifier, which I picked up at an antique space. I really love convex lenses, because they allow you to see things from like kind of acute angles, which is kind of nice, rather than like flat screens. But it might be hard to capture on film because it's going to kind of distort a bit, but there's a video of a rotoscope animation in there, and I really like how the lens picks up the lines from the animation and kind of flicks them out at a certain point and splits the light. I find that kind of really exciting, so you'll see where it goes a bit psychedelic. That animation is, again, like a lot of my work is about spinning and neurodivergence, and I was really lucky to work with two dancers, Jamal Sterrett and Danny Spooner, who kind of responded to some of my drawing work and made these beautiful dances that I've then animated. Cool. Thanks so much, Matt. This work here is a drawing, which I'm very lucky that I'm allowed to draw on the gallery walls, so I think that's super kind. I really like having a big substrate because it allows me to think about how my body kind of responds to the surface and get like material resistance. And because a lot of the subject of the exhibition is about material resistance of the site, the literal porosity of the Humber Estuary, that makes a lot of sense to me. So the drawing kind of mixes my spinning movements through kind of gestural line, alongside really thinking about the layers or the stratification of the Humber Estuary itself, and the way the like the dynamic mud flows is kind of super interesting to me. Cool. This work is again a really lovely Queenie helped me hand this work so that you can see the profile edge a bit better. So it's a carved piece that was made at Duke's Makes in Leeds. It's CNC milled and plywood. I'm really interested in how the process of CNC milling means that the profile edge is carved one line at a time, has that super repetitive action, which is quite like spinning. The edge itself is just taken, the profile is extended across the piece and there's a drawn line taken from the Humber Estuary. And what's kind of projected onto it are multiple scans from my walks along the estuary, kind of colliding into each other. It's just a really short bit of footage. I really like how there's just like a cluster of scans that spatially kind of interrupt each other. And again, I really enjoy how it kind of like fails to capture all of the information. And it again talks to my visual impairment, and I like making those connections. Thanks. These works are all about inscription, kind of taking away materials rather than adding them. Much like the drawing, I'm interested in, with neurodivergence, a lot of people have issues with proprioception, kind of knowing where the body is in space, and ways to kind of handle that for me are like pushing up against surfaces, like I often do this kind of gesture, just to remind myself where my body is in space. And I like translating that into materials as something really nice, rather than adding onto a substrate, kind of taking away. So these are kind of carved forms, thinking again, both about spinning and the estuary site. This sculpture here kind of goes back a bit more to my previous work, which I'm still thinking about, is really about twisting of the body. So I have a condition called Tourette's, where I have motor tics, they're quite painful, but like my body often twists through the spine and I kind of suppress that quite a lot. And I've been working in a lot of my sculpture with ways of kind of capturing that ephemeral moment and kind of just putting it in the material. So that's what that stone carving is about. The one next to it is just taken from my drawings of the estuary and different shapes and forms of the mudflats that kind of keep appearing in the work. They're both from limestone. This is a super nice limestone. This one has all the pebbles in it and was hard to carve. So this is a work I'm really happy with. It's made from Velcro mat, which is a more sustainable kind of source than kind of MDF. And it's kind of pigmented all the way through, so it's yellow all the way through. And it's taken from images of me kind of stretching. I was quite excited by this idea of being in an environment and being able to stretch. So stretching is something that really helps with my disability, because I like dislocate my joints like, all the time, and being able to stretch kind of just helps with the pain and stuff. And I was kind of considering how in like the site that I'm working in, it would be really frowned on me to just stretch out. But I've kind of, I've made a sculpture that talks about that and how the dynamics of the site like resist the kind of actions that would make me comfortable. So like a lot of my other work, it's about time and space. So there's layers and you can hopefully see the body moving through it. I'm really interested in like radial forms. Because they talk to me about like sensory information coming in from the outside into the body, and how that connects to neurodivergence.
Cool.
I'd like to show you the vinyl that the wonderful Emily from 87 Gallery made. She did such a nice job with making that sculpture in vinyl. I really love it. But it's super important to me to have easy read information as a primary source rather than a secondary, because I have like cognitive difficulties, and sometimes when I'm super tired I can't like read at all and like take things in. So having things in a format that's accessible is just really cool, I think, so I'm like really chuffed. And like as a layer bit of interpretation, so there's more information about the work, like the research, but people can choose whether or not they access that. And I like the decentralizing of like theory and written information as not being the primary modes of interacting. And we'll talk about it a bit more because we've created a touch library upstairs. These works are mallets, like made out of wax. I'm really excited by the way that wax can stand in almost like for a proxy of the body. When you touch it, it's kind of warm. And there's something about a mallet not being used, like maybe looks even a bit comic, but when Heidegger writes about the hammer, he suggests that we don't think about the hammer until it kind of fails. So we like incorporate tools within our body. And like as a disabled person, that always, it never resonated with me, even though I'm like really interested in phenomenology. Because I always think about a tool, because hammers are super heavy, and I always have to think about
really deliberate action so that I don't dislocate my joint or my fingers or my wrist. So there's always a consideration of the weight of them and this idea of them being like unusable because they're made out of wax really appealed to me, but it also allows me to think of that material resistance between the material of the wax and the material of the site. And there's loads of stuff about these, but like I also use mallets to carve, kind of with the limestone that we saw earlier. And it kind of, for me, connects to the site in terms of the Humber Estuary's connection to shipbuilding as well. But they would have used a different kind of mallet, which is like a caulking mallet. But I really like these round head mallets because they would have been used to carve figureheads. So there's like more of an aesthetic connection and a slowing down of time. So I'm really into that. This work is just about movement in the estuary. This is just me playing about a bit. I kind of wanted two forms kind of moving over each other, and then I was like, oh, they look like lips, I really like them. So it's just a bit playful. this work hanging, I'm like a massive fan of Noguchi, and he's had some wonderful hanging works in an exhibition we saw last year. But the colours in each of the voids are just taken from various photographs of the Humber Estuary. I was quite keen to pick out colours that you might not expect. It's very often like kind of brown or like dark grey or blue, but actually all of those colours were present in different photographs that I took. Thanks to Lucy for sending all these down. These are just to allow people to handle the materials. I'm really keen on being able to touch materials because it's, for me, it's just an important way of interpreting artwork as reading about it or learning about it, is having that physical, like, embodied experience. This artwork, I wasn't really like super happy with when I made, but it, like, for me, it's kind of important in storytelling. It kind of mixes the two interests, so it's got the layers of sediment, thinking about the surfaces of the mud flats, but it also has the twisting of the body. And like aesthetically, I didn't like it at all, and I was like, actually, it's telling the exact story that I want to tell, so I need to include it. And it's super tactile as well, if you like touching rough stuff, which my partner doesn't. Becky will have put together some books. I think they're on their way. But here are some in the meantime that kind of connect to the exhibition, which is really nice of them. AC7 Gallery have a really cool thing where they can bring artists' books in for the exhibition, and then the library stock them after, which is so cool. This I was really keen to have as part of the exhibition. So this is the Touch Library. This is like different. I just made like a cast of like my hand movements, but thinking about the layers of the mud in the estuary, and same here too. This is made out of like a jesmonite aggregate, and this one is like a jesmonite resin. And then I wanted people to be able to feel like the stone feel, because I've used quite a lot of stone. And then these are like just little wooden forms, because obviously there's a lot of wood in the exhibition too. But I like the way that you can handle them. I've just carved little notches in, and they support little stimming actions, which is obviously super relevant to my practice. I intend to make loads of these and take them out to the estuary so that people can kind of handle them as they're walking. This is a
from Lucy's dad, which is really nice. Lucy, you work there, thank you. It's a map of the estuary. This is like a concrete form. I made it super small because I'm not sure about like the embodied energy in concrete as a material, but I wanted to test out the form. My hope is to make it much bigger, but with hempcrete, which is a more sustainable source. But it's just shows my spine twisting. It's a really simple form. Next to it is a wax mallet, and it's actually in a film that myself and Matt made, where we're testing the physicality of the mallet against the ground next to the river hull. So we smashed it, which was kind of fun and cool. And then I've rebonded it together, just there. I like that it's got like so many layers of like breakages and repatching in it. I like it as an object. This is a painting I did at Feral Arts in the Hull. I really recommend Feral Arts. They're a great like learning space. But below it is some work that I did with Creative Connections in the 87 Gallery. And we were thinking about stimming quite a lot. So there's some drawing as stimming work. And on top of it are some plaster tiles that have been carved into, thinking again about stimming actions. And they're pretty cool. and finally, is the film that myself and Matt made. So with the LiDAR scans, I was interested in how it failed to capture the water, and I wanted to re-look at the body next to the edges of the site. So we did a lot of work about kind of touching the edges literally, so the railings along the estuary, and thinking about material resistance again and stimming in the body. And then after that is another film that I made that kind of segments all of the scans together and animates them. And then I think that is everything. So thank you so much, and thank you, Matt, for filming this.